Welcome, geometry students. We're going to work on the converse of the Pythagorean theorem again in this video. So have your paper and pencil ready, follow along, and we're going to work through two steps. First of all, we're going to solve question A, is it a triangle? So to solve that, we are just going to verify that it's a triangle by adding the two smaller sides, 5 plus 6, and if that is greater than the third side, we have a triangle, and 11 is greater than 7. So yes, we have a triangle, and now we can try to classify it. So now for part B, we're going to go back and look at our numbers 5, 6, and 7, and we're going to put them in order so that we are doing the Pythagorean theorem's converse. So we're going to look at c squared and compare it to a squared plus b squared. C has to be the hypotenuse, the longest side, so it is 7. So we're going to compare 7 squared, or 49, to 5 squared plus 6 squared. They're called the legs. If 5 and 6 are interchangeable, it doesn't matter which one is substituted for A or B. So we do our calculations and we have 49. We want to compare it to 25 plus 36. 25 plus 36 is 61. So 49 is less than 61, and therefore we have an acute triangle. And you've worked with the Pythagorean theorem's converse once again.